numbers are abstract and are therefore very difficult to memorize them. For example, you can easily conceptualize the biological functions and the workings of physics. But how would you conceptualize 2 plus 2 is equal to 4? Or how would you conceptualize your spouse's phone number, birthday, anniversary, or passcode? Luckily, there are well-established methods to memorize numbers. In this video, you will learn the measure method, also known as a phonetic system for numbers. This is a straightforward and easy to implement method. You are going to enjoy it. Once you master this method, your perspective toward numbers will change. Welcome to HyperQuick Brain, where you will learn the science of effective learning, memory improvement, and increasing your reading speed. Without further ado, let's dig into the details. As stated earlier, numbers are abstract, so we must transform this abstract concept into something tangible and easy to grasp. In measure method, each number from 0 to 9 is assigned a particular sound or letter. Then we convert those letters into meaningful words. Those words are again converted into memorable visualizations. This will become clear once we take up examples. First, let's see which sound is assigned to which letter. 0, S or Z. 1, T or D. 2, N. 3, M. 4, R. 5, L. 6, G or J. 7, K or C. 8, F or V. 9, P or B. Now, let's see how to remember this number to letter association using the mnemonic reminder. 0 starts from Z and S has a similar sound to Z. T and D have 1 downstroke. N has 2 downstrokes. M has 3 downstrokes. 4 ends with the letter R. L is Latin for 50. 6 is upside down G, and Z sounds similar to G. K is made from 2 subends joined like this, and K sounds like C. 8 looks like a handwritten F, and F sounds like V. P is a mirror of 9 and sounds like B. Don't worry if you don't get this right away. A downloadable PDF has been provided in the description, or you can find all the resources at www.hyperquickbrain.com/resources. Download and keep it for future reference. If you don't want to use the mnemonic reminders, you can use the flashcards. Take a blank piece of paper, cut it into equal sizes. On one side of the card, write the number 0 and on the reverse side, write S or Z. Do this for all the numbers for 0 to 9. Jumble them up and pick one card at a time. Recall the opposite side. You have to memorize this forward and backward. Meaning, if you see 0, you should be able to link it to S or Z. And if you see S or Z, you should be able to link it to 0. We are done with how to memorize the number letter association. Now, let's see how this technique works. Assume you need to memorize that your friend's birthday is 25th February, that is 2502. 2 is N, 5 is L, 0 is S or Z, and again 2 is N. By using the assigned sounds, we have to construct a meaningful word. The vowels and unassigned letters can be used to form the word. Let's construct it as Nelson. Here N is 2, E is unassigned, L is 5, S is 0, O is unassigned, and N is 2. So Nelson becomes 2502. You can link it to your friend's birthday by using the link or the story method. Imagine Nelson putting a cake on top of your friend. Make some bizarre and absurd connection. Another example, let's take a simple word, fan. F is 8, A is unassigned, and N is 2. So the fan represents 82. Now let's try to memorize a historical date. Assume you have to memorize that the Second World War started in 1939. 1 is S or Z, 9 is P or B, 3 is M, and 9 is again P or B. What comes to your mind when you think about the Second World War? For many people, it's Hitler. So we will use Hitler to memorize the Second World War. 1939 can be converted into zip map. Z for 1, P for 9, M for 3, and P for 9. So zip map is 1939. We are again going to use the link method. Imagine Hitler opening up his zip and pulling out a map. Make some bizarre and absurd connections to make them memorable. This way, you can utilize the measure method to memorize anything related to numbers. In future videos, as a demonstration, we will try to memorize complicated information such as lists of constitutional articles or fundamental rights using this method. Be sure to subscribe not to miss future training videos. If you have any complicated information that you want me to try it for you, put it in the comment. I will try to demonstrate it. However, to make those visualizations linked together, you need to make use of the link method. The link method has already been explained in this video. Click here to watch the video or check the link from the description. Finally, congratulations on learning something helpful today. Subscribe to get your bi-weekly training videos.